In the previous videos, we saw some code snippets for publisher and subscriber ROS nodes and explored some utility commands for finding information regarding a running ROS application. In order to be able to build our own application, we will have to write our own code files. Where do we put these files? How are they organized? Let's find out. Let me begin with introducing two terms used in ROS file system. First, a ROS workspace, in particular, a catkin workspace. And within the context of a ROS workspace, there is a source space, a devel space, a build space, and something we will not focus on in this course, an install space. And the second term is ROS package, which can be used to organize different functional modules in a ROS software application. Let's understand these terms one by one. We will first learn what is a catkin workspace in ROS. First, a ROS workspace is a folder in your computer where you can organize various ROS project files. Second, catkin is a build tool that compiles the source code files in a project into executable binaries. Well, it does a lot more, but this understanding is sufficient in the context of this course. So, a catkin workspace is a ROS workspace that uses catkin as a build tool. Let's now look at an example catkin workspace and its contents before we create one of our own. Here, we see a typical folder structure within a ROS catkin workspace. All your code files go in the source folder, written as src and called as the source space. Code from others can also go in here only if you are changing it. Otherwise, simply install the corresponding binaries and keep your source space clean. The log files containing debug information associated with the various software modules in a project are in the logs folder called the log space. The files for setting up a project-specific ROS environment are in the devel folder. Along with these files, the devel folder also contains the executables of your source files for development and testing. The build space used by the build tool catkin to store some intermediate files like object files during the build process. When we write code for our own ROS applications, the source folder is our playground. The remaining folders are generated by the build tool catkin. Let's now find out how to create our own catkin workspace for a ROS application. We first create the new workspace folder, including the source space. A common practice is to do this in the user's home folder, but I prefer to do it in a separate folder named ROS inside the home folder, so that all my ROS workspaces are in one place. As we can see, the new workspace appears in the list, along with some other workspaces as well. Now, we go to the newly created workspace and set up the base ROS environment we will work with. In this course, we are working with ROS Kinetic. Therefore, we source the setup files of ROS Kinetic installation. Then, we run the command catkin init, which makes the workspace folder into a catkin workspace. Also, we can see that the source space exists while the remaining have not yet been created because we have not yet built our workspace. Therefore, we now run the catkin build command, which will generate the missing spaces.